بسم الله.
بسم الله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين، وصلى الله على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه يا رب العالمين. باب ما جاء في الذبح لغير الله. This chapter is so important. باب ما جاء في الذبح لغير الله. It's the chapter what comes about a person who is slaughters for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. أي ذبح البهائم. Slaughtering the animals for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a Muslim, if we want to sacrifice an animal, we can do it for two types. One is for a consumption. This animal, our intention is that we are going to kill it and consume it as a meal. That one is permissible. And the other one is slaughtering for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this has caused so many fitna in the Muslim community or in the Muslim ummah. Some people, they slaughter it for the jinn. And there's plenty in the Muslim society. People who are slaughtering sheep or a ram, or a cow, or a goat, or a camel for the jinn, to make the jinn happy. And I have seen some people who slaughter for the jinn, and they invite it. They make a deal with the jinn so they can invite the jinn after every 6 months. And I have seen an animal which was given to the jinn. They sacrifice for the jinn. They don't slaughter it. This animal is standing there, and the whole body of the animal is shaking. It's shaking, 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 and then it will fall into one side, and collapse it, and it will die. Subhanallah. So it become like dead animal, which no one can eat. First, it was sacrificed for jinn, and then now, it is dead animal. It has not been slaughtered according to the Sharia. So some people, they slaughter animals for the sea. They take the animal to the seashore because they believe that this blood that is coming from the animal will stop the sea coming into the, like when they are scared of having like tsunami. So they slaughter an animal, they shed the blood to stop the sea coming into the city or coming into their area. Subhanallah. And some people, they slaughter the animals for spirits, which we don't even see. So they slaughter for the jinn, they slaughter for the spirits, they slaughter for as a sign of when a great man is coming. If you slaughter and distribute the meat to the people and to welcome that great person, it's not haram. But if you are sacrificing it for the sake of that person, to magnify him, to make him bigger, then it will be like shirk. So this is too much fitna in the Muslim ummah. They slaughter the animal for the wind that blows. So they slaughter the animal for the wind, for the jinn, for the spirit, for graves, for the seashore, for so many things. It depends on the intention. But as a muwahid, someone who is about the tawheed, we only slaughter the animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a ibadah. Like you are not allowed to pray other than Allah. Can you pray to somebody else other than Allah? No. Can you fast for another person? No. You can pray salah to only Allah. You can fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the same way, you can only slaughter the animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said in the Quran, قُلْ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةِ إِنَّ أَدْوَاتُ تَوْكِيد is توكيد, is emphasizing. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةِ indeed my salah. وَنُسُكِ نُسُك is like slaughtering animals in like the, when you are performing the Hajj, that animals that you give to those who deserve, that's called nusuk. Wamahiyaya, my life, my whole life. Wamamati, and my death. Lillahi, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My whole life, means my whole life is based upon tawheed. And my death, لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ is for Allah, the Lord of the worlds. The Lord of the worlds, this world and the next life. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ there is no partner with him, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So all my life, I will live according to his sharia and I will die upon tawheed. My salah and my nusuk, nusuk means slaughtering animals for the sake of Allah during the Hajj, that one is called. La sharika lahu, and there's no partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to be very careful. When you are slaughtering an animal, there must be two conditions. First of all, you must have the intention that you are slaughtering this animal for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not for the sake of anyone else. The second one is, when you are slaughtering the animal, you have to slaughter the animal with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillah. Bismillah, Allahu Akbar. You have to mention the name of Allah. Otherwise, that animal cannot be consumed by a Muslim. You have to mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say Bismillah, and your intention is that this ibadah will take you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those are the two conditions. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ. Allah is talking to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, فَصَلِّ O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, pray your salah. لِرَبِّكَ, pray for your Lord. وَانْحَرْ, النَّحْرُ especially, not all the animals. النَّحْرُ is special for the camels only. The slaughtering of the camels is called in Arabic an-nahar. Wanhar, that means pray to your Lord and sacrifice the camels for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And subhanallah, some people, they give so many animals to the jinn, to the spirit, to the wind that blows here and there, they slaughter animals. and the jinn and the spirit will come and they will suck the blood out of the animal. I have seen one day they bring a big lorry full of Fanta, bottles of Fanta, and one young girl can drink all of it. Subhanallah. And they make a deal with the jinn, they make a contract that the jinn will come back to this young girl every 6 months. So they have to give the jinn dates, they have to give sweets, and they have to celebrate, they have to dance, they have to like a wedding. So they are worshipping the jinn rather than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is kufr, this is disbelief. Anyone who does that, he doesn't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He doesn't have a tawheed. If he dies on that situation, he will go, directly go to the hellfire. Because the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, man mata wa huwa yad'u min dunillahi niddan dakhala an-nar. Whoever dies while worshipping or taking other gods beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will go to the hellfire. Subhanallah. So where is, why did Allah send his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to us? Why? To take us from the darkness into the light. To take us from polytheism, shirk, into tawheed. To take us from blindness into the light. To take us from ignorance into knowledge. So, subhanallah, when the Sahaba, they accepted Islam, and some of them, when they become Muslim, they discard all the false gods that they used to worship. They completely discard it. They discard it. Like Amr bin Jamuh radiallahu anhu, he was so militant in worshipping his own God inside his house. And then his wife and his two sons, they accepted Islam. So they could not convince him that these idols cannot help him. So what they did, they took his statue and they tied it to a dead dog. Then when he came, he said, where's my God? They said, we don't know, Baba, just find it. He went out, he started searching his own idol, and he found his God and Savior and tied to a dead dog. But he was intelligent. Then he said, wallahi, you are not a God. So he said, take me to the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then he took his shahada. Subhanallah. So we are Muslims. Allah blessed us with tawheed. But it seems that people are bit by bit gradually going back to polytheism, going back to disbelief, going back to shirk. Subhanallah. I saw when I was in like Somalia, subhanallah, I was in a small city, and there was a wind blowing. Sometimes you see a green wind that just blowing here and there, and people, they were pointing their fingers, Yahya Mawrif, Yahya Mawrif, Yahya Mawrif. What is this Yahya Mawrif? And when I asked them, what do you mean Yahya and Mawrif, they said, there are two spirits that control the wind. See the disbelief. Who controls the wind? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these crazy lunatic people, they made this masakin forget the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What are the rights of Allah? That you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. If you sacrifice with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you pray salah, pray to Allah. If you fast, fast for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no spirit, there is no jinn, there is no Haji Salaban, they call Haji Salaban. I don't know. Haji Salaban was a man. And then they, and there is, we had something that, especially women, have been brainwashed so into believing so all sorts of rubbish and nonsense. And they rob of their money. So, subhanallah. So Allah said, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَالْحَرْ Pray to your Lord. And وَالْحَرْ means slaughter, calmness. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. عن علي رضي الله عنه قال علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله تعالى عنه said حدثني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بأربع كلمات. The messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم told me four words. They are beautiful words. So the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said لعن الله من ذبح لغير الله. لعن الله. May Allah curse من ذبح لغير الله. Whoever slaughters animal for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you have intention of slaughtering and sacrificing animals for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means you have been cursed by the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why did the messenger curse? Because they are committing shirk. Subhanallah. So this is a grave sin. And a major sin. Slaughtering animals. How many conditions we mentioned?
Two.
Mm-hmm.
So first one has to be for the sake of Allah.
Mm-hmm.
You have to say
Bismillah. MashaAllah. Barakallahu feek. These are the two conditions. Can you repeat? You have to sacrifice for the sake of Allah. And the second one is?
Say Bismillah.
Mention the name of Allah. Otherwise, it's totally haram to consume it and to eat. If you are invited to a gathering where the people have this kind of meat, if they don't slaughter with the name of Allah, and their intention is not to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you are not allowed to attend.
What's your opinion on those who say if you're in the lands of the Christians or the Jews and they sacrifice their meat, you are allowed to consume it? What would you say?
Okay, Bismillah. That's a good question. Is if they are the people of the book,
no.
They believe that Isa alayhi salam was a messenger of Allah, not as a son of God. They believe. And they are still about the religion of Isa alayhi salam and the religion of Musa alayhi salam, even though those two religions have been replaced with Quran and Sunnah. Still, if they are the people of the book, their food and their women have been allowed to us.
Mm.
We can marry them, we can eat their... But today we ask, do we find them? It's very difficult to find them. I think majority of the Europeans nowadays, they are atheists.
Yeah, I wouldn't consider this country.
Yes, or agnostic. They don't even believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't believe in any scripture. They don't believe in the day of judgment. They don't believe anything. So how can you eat what they have slaughtered? You cannot. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لعن الله من ذبح لغير الله. May Allah curse whoever sacrifices an animal for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether it's for a spirit, for a jinn, for a Satan, There are certain worshippers now. Have you ever heard certain worshippers? Yeah. They are the devil worshippers or Satan worshippers, and they are everywhere. Even some, they call themselves ex-Muslims. They do that. They do that. Then the Messenger of Allah said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ لَعَنَ وَالِدَيْهِ. May Allah curse the one that curses his parents. Then the Sahaba, they were surprised. They said, is there anyone who will curse his parents? Then the Messenger of Allah give beautiful explanation. He said, فَيَصُبُّ أَبَا أَحَدٍ فَيَصُبُّ أَبَاهُ. He will insult and abuse someone's dad, and that in retaliation, what's he going to do? He will insult you back. So that is who caused your dad to be insulted? You, because you started. And your mom the same way. So if you insulted someone's dad or mom, then he will not sit. He will retaliate. He will insult your mom and your dad. That is why in Islam we have akhlaq, we have ethics. Why should you insult anyone? Even if he insults you, you can retaliate. But what's better? Not to retaliate. And otherwise you will be equal. Two jahil, يعني. Two ignorants who are insulting each other.
Sheikh, you know, I think was the treaty of Ridwan bin Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was swearing at the God. Would that be permissible then in certain situation to be in a type of way?
Yes, yes. So the Messenger said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ لَعَنَ وَالِدِهِ. May Allah curse the one who causes his two parents to be cursed or insulted by other people. Then he said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ آوَى مُحْدِثًا. لَعَنَ اللَّهُ. May Allah curse مَنْ آوَى مُحْدِثًا. Whoever gives shelter to an innovator, someone who makes bid'ah into the deen, whoever gives shelter, may Allah curse him. And someone has done a bid'ah or innovation into the deen, and he was kicked out by maybe his community, his family, he came to you and you give him a shelter. You are going to protect him. If you do that, you will be cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, also the same way someone has committed a crime, maybe he has slain someone, he chopped off the head of that person, and then he came to your house. Please, my friend, my brother, protect me. And you are so powerful, you give him protection. You are also cursed because you have to hand that person over to the law. You have to hand him over to the law of Islam. Because that is what he deserves. Like, subhanAllah, in some communities, a husband has murdered and killed his own wife, and then he mutilated her body, subhanAllah. He mutilated her body, and then he fled from the area, and he took shelter with his tribe, with his family, and they said, hey, this is our son. We are going to protect that whole society, or that whole family will be cursed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because They are evil people.
So did that happen in the Jahiliya, you know, that time?
And even now it's happening.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I think it's a green news with what I'm talking about. They are even happening now. Yes, even now it's happening. Somehow. This man, what he did recently, just it was like in this month, he killed his own wife, mutilated her body, and then he completely bent her down, astaghfirullah, until her body became like charcoal. SubhanAllah. So, ultimately, he was arrested, alhamdulillah. Then the Messenger said, لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ غَيَّرَ مَنَارَ الْأَرْضِ. May Allah curse whoever changes the landmarks of the of borders. That means now you own a land. There's your Muslim brother has got another land next to you. What do? In the night time they move. The evil man will move night time 2 inches. Every night he will move like, subhanAllah, 1 step to his brother. And then he will take maybe 25% of his Muslim brother's land, which is haram. And still so many people, they do it. And so that's why the Messenger of Allah has cursed لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ غَيَّرَ مَنَارَ الْأَرْضِ. May Allah curse anyone who jumps the landmarks of the borders between Muslims.
Sheikh, can you say that about countries as well?
Of course.
Two Muslim countries.
Yes, they cannot push each other. Because the Muslims, see, there's no border between Muslims. No border at all. The Muslims are one body. So you can travel to that, they can come to you. But these borders have been created by the imperialists and the colonizers. When they came to our countries, they divided us, divide and rule.
Well, Sheikh, you know, is that only for Muslims then? Or like, you know, Britain, for example, they colonized the earth. They put lines everywhere. So Allah's curse would be on
everyone who does that.
Not just Muslims, anyone.
No, not anyone, anyone. This one is anyone, not only the everyone. لَعَنَ اللَّهُ مَنْ عَنَ إِسْمُ الْجِنْسِ is عُمُومِ عَنَ it will generalize everything. رواه مسلم. The hadith is narrated by Imam Muslim. So how many people have been cursed? Now, how many people in this hadith have been cursed? How many people?
Four.
Four, okay. The first one? Okay. Four of them. Okay, mention. One by one.
The one is the one who cursed parents.
Mm-hmm.
The one who changed the boundaries.
Mm-hmm.
The one who
gives shelter.
Yeah, the one who gives shelter.
Mm-hmm.
And slaughter.
The one who had that changed the landmarks of borders. Yes.
I said that one.
You said that one.
Okay.
Rawah Muslim. So. Why I'm asking the question is because I want you to be with me, inshallah. So this hadith, mashallah, is Rawahu Muslim. It's one of the highest standards of hadith. So authentic, mashallah. So we have to be careful not to be from those people who have been cursed by the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And this hadith, mashallah, is also very good. The one is coming now. وعن طارق بن شهاب أن الرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. The Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, دخل الجنة رجل في ذباب. A man entered the Jannah because of a fly. سبحان الله. Because of a fly, he was granted to paradise. ودخل النار رجل في ذباب. And a man, the man was not mentioned because it's not important. وَدَخَلَ النَّارَ رَجُلٌ فِي الدُّبَابٍ. And a man entered as well to the hellfire because of a fly, this normal fly, the insect one. قالوا وكيف ذلك يا رسول الله. They said, how did that happen? How can a man go to the paradise because of a fly? And how can a man be granted to paradise, to the hellfire because of a fly? Look what they did. قال مر رجلان على قوم. He said two individuals, two men, they crossed by a group of people. They passed by a group of people. لهم صنم, who had an idol. He had a statue. لا يجوز أحد, no one will be allowed to cross حتى يقرب له شيئا, until he sacrifices something for their idol. Like they have a checkpoint here, and they will not allow anybody to cross their checkpoint until he sacrifices something. فقالوا لأحدهما, they said to one of them, قرب. He sacrificed something that will take closer to our idol. قال ليس عندي شيء أقرب. He said, I don't have anything to sacrifice to your idol, to your statue. قالوا له قرب ولو ذبابا. They said to him, sacrifice even it's a little fly. فقرب ذبابا. Then what did he do? He took one fly and he cut its head as a sign of sacrifice and give to the sanam, to the idol. فخلوا سبيله, and then they let him go. They said, you have sacrificed something to our idol, go. فدخل النار, and he, because of that, he went to where? To the hellfire. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Because of a fly. What do you think those who will sacrifice goats, sheep, cows, camels for Jailani, for Sayyid al-Badawi, for Aydarus, for all those, subhanAllah. What do you think? Those who sacrifice for the jinn, for graves, for the saints and the awliya, they sacrifice. What do you think? Subhanallah. Last night, I have that one. If you want, you can listen later on. There was I think he's in Pakistan. He's speaking Urdu and Arabic. He says to the people, the people are so ignorant, so jahil. I don't know what rubbish they listen to. He says to them, if you want, make contact to Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani. I have got his number. 6668. He mentions the number and he says, I'm calling Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jailani. A'udhu billahi min al-jahl. Wallahi, I have it here. A'udhu billahi min al-jahl. Why do I need to call anyone other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And that Sheikh, may Allah shower his mercy on him, he's already in his grave. We don't know where he is. We don't know. Only Allah knows his destination. Only Allah knows that. So why do they fabricate lies about him? فَدَّخَلَ نَارُ وَقَالُوا لِأَخْرَ. And then they said to the second one, قَرِّبْ. Sacrifice something. فَقَالَ مَا كُنْتُ لِأُقَرِّبَ لِأَحَدٍ شَيْئًا دُونَ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ. He said, I am not in a position to sacrifice anything for other than Allah. Never, that will never happen. Then what did they do? فَضَرَبُوا عُنُقَهُ. They cut his neck. They chop off his neck. فَدَخَلَ الْجَنَّةَ. And he went where? To paradise. Rawahu Ahmed. Because he died about Tawheed. So this hadith, they, scholars, they said, it's Marasil al-Sahaba. It's some sort of hadith that it comes from the side of the companions of the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. It is an authority. So This chapter, mashallah, is so important. We have to be very careful what we are sacrificing for. As we mentioned, the people they sacrifice for different intentions, for the jinn, for spirit, for irfid, for iblis, a'udhu billahi min darji, for trees, for tombs, for graves, for rih, the wind, and even I saw some people, they give babies the blood of those animals. They make them drink. Disgusting. Once you abandon the tawheed, this will be your situation. Every ignorant will keep you in a cage. You know cage? You will be in that cage for him. And he will take you to any direction that he wants.
Sheikh, I know a story of a brother told me that a woman used to make her children go to the park after dark and give meat, leave meat there. They do this like every fortnight, every week or something. Now that I think about it, it's probably for what you said.
No.
For the shayateen.
Yeah. And even the messengers said, "Kufu sibyanakum," and keep your children, little children, after Maghrib, it's not allowed to take them outside. Because that time is the time that the shayateen, they circle everywhere, they move around. So, subhanallah, these people, they sacrificing only is allowed for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But these people nowadays, they sacrifice for, subhanallah, I have seen with my own eyes that ram or that male sheep was shaking like that. Shaking for half an hour. Then he will collapse. Subhanallah. Because they send, there are some evil people who send they send the jinn on that sheep. They use the jinn to attack and harm the Muslims. But unfortunately, some people, they call those people sheikh or scholar or a student of knowledge. Or they call him Mawlana, Imam. What is this?
Sheikh, you know, when I was back home, I went to this village and they slaughtered this cow. They said, "Allahu Akbar, Bismillah," everything.
Mm.
They made a hole and they made the blood go all in there.
Mm.
And they asked us to wash our hand. I was very small back then.
Mm.
Wash my hand. What do you think that is?
There may be black magic. You never know. These people, they are very dangerous.
Mm.
And even my mom told me, she said, we used to go to a grave and whenever we need rain, we go that one. We have biscuits, dates, tea, everything. And we believe someone told them that there is a well inside that grave. Then she said, after maybe 15 years, a man came. And I said, "What are you doing around this grave?" He said, "There is a well." There is a, mashallah. He said, No. He said, "My donkey died while I was with him, and I just put in this grave."
Yeah.
He said, "How can you insult the wali?" He said, "Move away." And he started digging, and he took the head of the donkey.
Yeah. The
donkey.
Donkey,
yes.
Oh, donkey.
Yeah, the head of a donkey he took out.
They were worshiping his donkey.
Then the people have to flee from that area. فيه مسائل قول إن صلاتي ونسكي. We tafsir the meaning of inna salati wa nusuki, we understand it. And the tafsir fasali rabbika walhar, we done it. Al-thalitha, al-bada'atu bil-la'nati man dhabaha lighayrillah. The messenger started to curse anyone who sacrifices for other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-rabi'a, la'anu man la'ana walidayhi. Cursing anyone who causes his two parents to be cursed by ومنه أن تلعن والدي الرجل فيلعن والديك. And it's that you curse someone's parents and he will retaliate. الخامسة لعن من آوى محدثا. The cursing of someone who protects and gives shelter to someone who is an innovator or someone who committed a crime. وهو رجل يحدث شيئا. He says someone who will make innovation يجب فيه حق الله. In something that Allah's rights is there. فيلتجي إلى من يجيره من ذلك. And he will go to someone who gives him a shelter. So if you give someone who makes innovation to the deen or has committed a crime, that means you also curse it. السادسة لعن من غير منار الأرض. It's also cursed anyone who changes the landmarks of the borders between the Muslims. وهي المراسيم التي تعرف بين حقك وحق جارك من الأرض. It's the landmarks that you will recognize. It's between you and the border between you and Muslim brother. Or even if he is not Muslim. فتغيرها بتقديم أو تأخير. And then you change it by moving back or forward. السابعة الفرق بين لعن معين ولعن أهل المعاصي على سبيل العموم. The difference between cursing an individual and as a general. So can you curse someone directly? No. Because you never know what is going to, if Allah will guide him or not. We only make dua for them. But you are allowed to curse the kuffar as a general. You are allowed to curse the innovators as a general. You are allowed to curse the woman who dress not properly. As a general. But you cannot say, may Allah curse this individual. You are not allowed. Because his fate is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And only Allah knows what is going to happen to him. الثامنة هذه القصة العظيمة. This great story. وهي قصة ذباء. It is the story of the fly. If someone went to the hellfire because of a fly, and someone was granted to the Jannah because of a fly, what do you think about those who are buying like cows, goats, chicken, everything? التاسعة كونه دخل النار بسبب ذلك الذباب الذي لم يقصده. He went to the hellfire because of that fly. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. Which he did not. The first one, he did not have the intention. They just tell him, and he did it. بل فعله تخلصا من شرهم. But he did it so he could escape from their evil intention. العاشرة معرفة قدر الشرك في قلوب المؤمنين. Knowing the magnitude of shirk in the hearts of the believers. كيف صبر ذلك على القتل. How that man had a patience because of being killed. ولم يوافقهم على ضلبهم. And he did not accept their request. مع كونهم لم يطلبوا إلا العمل الظاهر. Even though they did not ask him accept something that is open can be seen. الحادي عشر number 11 أن الذي دخل النار مسلم. The individual who went to the fire because of that fire was a Muslim. Because he was. But he fell into shirk. لأنه لو كان كافرا لم يقل دخل النار في ذباب. If he was a non-believer, if he was a non-believer, we, the hadith would not have said he went to the fire because of fly. الثاني عشر فيه شاهد لحديث صحيح الجنة أقرب إلى أحد إلى أحد إلى أحدكم من شراك عليه. We have that hadith which is narrated by Bukhari and Muslim that every one of you, the Jannah is no closer than the where you put your the sandal. What do you call that one?
Straps.
The straps of your sandals. Yes. وَنَارُ مِثْلُ ذَلِكَ and the hellfire is as close as well to you like the strips of your sandals. That means the Jannah is everywhere and the hellfire is also surrounding you. So you have to turn away from the hellfire and go to the Jannah, inshallah. ثالث عشر معرفة أن عمل القلب هو المقصود الأعظم. Knowing that the intention of the heart is the main intention. حتى عند عبادة الأوثان. Even those who worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I hope we have come to the end of the lesson, alhamdulillah. Is there any question related to the class? Mm-hmm.
You know, you said that you have to slaughter an animal, you have to say Bismillah and Allah Akbar. Do you know for like food that like, can I not eat fish from Tesco?
Fish?
Yeah.
Fish is, doesn't need, it's always halal fish.
Yeah?
Yes. Okay. Because fish doesn't need to be slaughtered. It's, when it comes out of the sea, it's there. Yeah.
Say, you know, back home, normally when they invite you, they slaughter a chicken, cow, or whatever the case is. But they're not slaughtering you for the sake of Allah, they're slaughtering you to feed you. That'd be a haram or shirk.
Or for what?
They're slaughtering you to feed you.
No, that's not a problem, yeah. Yeah. But if they're slaughtering to respect someone like that one, it's not allowed. But if they slaughter it for a consumption,
yeah,
there's no problem with that. And one day I saw it, you can see there in, I think, where they play football, there is a restaurant. It's written halal fish. Halal fish.
Oh, yeah. Halal fish.
Halal fish.
I saw a video of this man using a crossbar. You know, there's a big black stone that people go to. And he said, you're all committing shirk. Because you're always making
du'a
and writing your names. Did he do the right things by doing?
What did he write?
No, so he was telling